71.
Let's say that again. How many grandchildren does he have?
71.
71 grandchildren. This is mysterious and miraculous.
Okay. He said there's no TV in the Philippines, but I don't believe that. I think they just got so busy.
So many babies.
Every year.
We like madness babies. Anyway, he has all these stories. But tell us a bit about Anita's life. What was the one factor in her life that she did over and over and over again?
My mom is a very wonderful and godly woman. When she and my dad separated for a long, long time, she bore 12 kids, but 10 of us live. And then when she came to the Lord in the Philippines, she was telling me this, she had 9 kids living. And she's by herself, and she's a self-employed and supporting all these children. But with her faith so strong, she tried. And with all the children, she put some of them in college to the Baptist missionary or
seminary.
So anyway, my mom never stopped working, supporting the children.
And how did she work? Tell her what she did when she worked
We all work going out and doing the fish business. We have a fish business back home. It's a smoke house, we call them. And in the morning we get up and get into the boat. Of course, they used to use dynamite when I was young to go fishing. But when we get the fish, we start cutting the fish and lay out. Or we smoke the fish and we get up like 12 o'clock. My dad wake me up all the time at 12 midnight. To take fish, smoked fish, to every different, just like Bakersfield, you go to McFarland, all the way to the Lane or Fresno. So we have those accounts until we go to our own place. So that happens for so long until they separated because my dad got into this alcohol problem. But my mom stood on her faith and she never quit. And one thing about my mom that I will always remember, I was telling Pastor Roger and Pastor Phil, she likes to share the love of God. She likes to share. And she likes to always give us the sermon, no matter how young and old, all my brothers and sisters, she never quit. So when she's by herself, she will always read the Bible to us. And she will read the Bible every year. She knows from Old Testament to New Testament. And when I start doing that, I have to call my mom on some, and she will just tell me all about it and which word to look for. But my mom's attitude towards God, she is so faithful. And wherever I take her on vacation, cruise or Las Vegas, this is no kidding, she will not forget to bring the tracts of the church. And she's got English and Spanish. I take her to Alaska, as soon as she get off the boat, she is going out there and soul winning. She will never quit. And I keep telling my mom, are you going to a shopping? This is my shopping. I'm shopping for people. But anyway, you know, I always joke with my mom, she never carries credit card, but people always don't leave home without your credit card. Hers, don't leave home without the tracks. And she goes to Mexican Riviera, and she's ready, she's got the Spanish. And she goes to the mall here, and sometimes she gets kicked out by the security, but she's so like, you know, Jesus loves you, okay, and she goes on, Jesus loves you. That's all she had to say. That's all she had to share. And when I had a bar and a restaurant in Tehachapi, she works for me for a long time. And my mom never fails to go to the bar and put a TBN in my bar. Can you imagine people drinking in the TBN on the bar? Like, yay. So she started doing that. And in the morning when my customer comes to the bar and I share this with Pastor Bill, Phil, it was kind of like nice in a way, but this is business, you know. At the time I wasn't saved, of course. And she will serve the stadium next with the customer, and the customer would drink beer in the morning. And I just kind of noticed about this one guy, James. I said, James, what's wrong with you? And he said, oh, nothing, because he's got a teary eye. And I said, what's wrong, Nanay? What happened to James? And he said, well, Nanay made me cry because she started preaching at me. I said, Nanay, this is, well, I was just telling him, why does he have to drink, you know, beer in the morning? You know, like, this is the temple. I mean, she just started. That's all she does. All she talks about is about God. But to be honest with you, I met this guy here in Bakersfield. Praise the Lord, he got saved. James don't drink anymore. And I'm sure there is more that my mom did. She went to the bus station. She loves to take bus because that's her ministry at the bus station. She will get all these people a track. And she will just hand it to them. She never gets tired. So, you know, she left us a good legacy here. And she never really, like, quit. And she's so naive. And I was telling Pastor Phil, I gotta tell this joke. And I was so busy at the restaurant cooking. And customer says, early there's a guy in the bar. And, you know, and my waitresses are busy. So I asked my mom, is our kitchen, go and check it out. So she came back. And, of course, she's looking in the drawer. And I asked her, stopped her. I said, what are you looking for, Mom? The guy in the bar wants a screwdriver. I said, Mom, I stopped. It's not a screwdriver. It's a drink. I gotta go over there. And I just like, you know. So that's how my mom is so naive. All she can think of is really share the word of God. She planted a seed in so many ways, in so many places. And even my son, when we go to Las Vegas, she start doing that when we have to see the show or fall in line in the restaurant. I will hear my son and say, Nanay, there's a time for sharing, hello. And she goes, I know, but this is the time. So I said, just leave grandma alone. She's happy what she's doing. So the time for my mom to share is every time. And she will tell people to go to church. Whenever you see the door open at the church, no matter what day, as soon as they're open, you go. That's the only way you can learn and you can receive the word of God and live the life that, you know, she did live the life that she
lived. How many of those 71 grandchildren are saved?
Oh my gosh, holy pastor, I've been praying for the rest of the family. Some of them, her first convert is my niece, the oldest one that sing the song for her. Yeah, because she shared that. And there's a lot of people, a lot of her grandkids too that got saved. I got saved through that because my mom's been praying for me. Of course, I was her rebellious kid. And of course, I gave up everything when April got into an accident, when I sold my business and the bar and restaurant. The restaurant's still open. I was thinking, my goodness, you know, I sold the bar and I'm just like, yay, everybody's gonna quit drinking. But that was my mentality. Drinking, but no. So anyway, it was like my mom is always praying for me about the bar, you know, get rid of it or whatever. This is my business, you know, and stuff like that. But her prayer, God answered it. And, you know, I got saved, and totally, I was just sold out.
That's good. That's the message I wanted you to hear. I wanted you to hear the story. Now, a seed was planted 30 years ago, and miraculously and mysteriously, it has grown now in an unbelievable way. Grandkids got up and sang at your mother's funeral, and nieces got up and sang songs about Jesus at this funeral. And I thought, look what happens when one somebody gets saved and their life gets turned around. Thank you so much, Early. We appreciate your testimony.